solutions. So the chemicals that play a very important role in our life. So the chemicals in the sense, the chemicals there are physical forms. The chemicals are in physical forms. So these chemicals, so they are mostly, the chemicals are mostly what? Mixtures. And some of them are rarely pure substances, these chemicals. So here we are going to see what is solution. So what is solution? Solubility and the concentration of the solution. So let's start. Let's see what is solution. So solutions are homogeneous mixtures of two or more than two components. So what is solution? It is the solutions are homogeneous mixtures of two or more than two components. So if you take a mixture, if it can be a 2, 3 or 4, any amount of mixtures if you take and then you mix it, the composition will be same. You will be getting a same composition. So that is what it is, a solution. That we call it as what? Solutions. So here if you see homogeneous. So what is homogeneous? So homogeneous. So homo. What is homo? Homo is same. So if you take a mixture, you are taking a mixture and what is happening? The composition is same in whole mixture. The composition is same in the whole mixture. Its property is also same in the whole mixture. That is what? Homogeneous. So the composition. Composition is same in the whole mixture. So that is what? It is a homogeneous solution. So let's take for an example, you are taking sugar and water. So here there are how many components? There are two components. One is sugar, the other one is water. So what are you doing now? You are going to mix. You are taking water and you are going to add sugar to the water. So what are you getting? You are getting a what? Sugar solution. You are getting a sugar solution. The whole composition, the sugar will be dissolved in the solution. So that is what? A homogeneous. This is an example of homogeneous mixture, homogeneous solution. So you have the same composition, all the sugar will be dissolved in the taken amount of water. So that is an example of what? It is an example of homogeneous solution. So solutions are homogeneous mixtures of two or more than two components. It can be two or more than two components also. If you add to the solution, you will be getting the same composition of the solution. So that we call it as what? Solution. And homogeneous solution is what? When you are dissolving a sugar to the water, and when you are dissolving it, the composition, you see the sugar solution, you will be getting the same composition, the whole sugar will be dissolved in the water. So that is homogeneous solution. So next if you see mixtures, here we saw the homogeneous. Next if you see mixtures, here two or more than two components, they combine. You can see the mixture separately in the solution. So here you cannot, you are going to see the same composition, here you won't be able to see the what? The sugar particles in that. But in mixture, if you see, the two or more than two components are separately, they are separate. So you can see the mixtures. So these mixtures, they do not combine with each other in the solution to form a single form. They do not combine with each other to form a single form. This is a uniform solution, but here if you see the mixture, the composition in the mixtures is not uniform. They are not combined with each other to form a single form. So their composition is not uniform in the mixtures. Mixtures do not have a uniform composition. So next if you see examples of solution, let's now see the examples of solution. So examples of solution, let's see the air itself, the air around us. If you take the air around us, so what is air? It is fully filled of gases. So gases like oxygen, nitrogen, carbon dioxide. So like that, gases are fully, like this, these types of gases are fully filled, and the whole composition, the same, it gives the what? Same composition as air. So these are the mixtures of gases. These mixtures of gases, when they combine together, we get the air. So this is what? It is an example of solutions. The next, if you take tea, coffee, or sugar solution, salt solution, if you see all these things, two or more than two components, when you add these solutions, what is happening? You get the what? You get the same composition, a simple composition you get in the solution. If you take cool drinks, so how the cool drinks are made, what do we add to the cool drinks? We add water, sugar, any flavor, and carbon dioxide. So these three components, when we add to the cool drinks, what is happening? These all mix together and you get a single composition, the same composition of the solution. So that is what, these are what? These are the examples of solution. I told you many examples, tea. So tea, milk, sugar, water, no, sugar, water. So all these you add and you get a homogeneous solution. So that is what, this is an example of solution of tea and sugar solution, salt solution. So these are all the examples of solution. So next we are going to see, so this discussion we are seeing these solutions that are liquid. Here we saw cool drinks, tea, coffee, sugar solution, salt solution, these are all in liquid form. Now we are going to see the solution in solid also. So solid, if you take, we are taking an example of brass, it is an alloy of water, copper plus zinc. Copper and zinc, when these both combine, these two metals, when they combine, you are getting water, you are getting the brass. So brass is the water, it is a solid solution. And if you take bronze, it is also a water, it is the two components, that is what, copper plus zinc, when these two mix together, you are getting the bronze. This is what, this is a solid solution. So here if you see, here also there are two or more than two components. So when two components when they combine, when they mix with each other and they give a same composition, a single composition of a solution, that is what, a solution. So this is the solid solution, examples of solid solution. In gaseous solution we saw the example of air, and in liquid solution we saw these examples, and this is an example of solid. So after this, when we see solutions, the solutions have two components in the solution. This much time we are telling about the two components. And two components, like examples, we saw sugar plus water, two components, when they combine, we get a sugar solution. So let's see what is that two components. So what is the term determined for these two components? So the two components in the solutions are, one is solvent, the other one is solute. One is solvent and other one is solute. So if you take the solvent, the component that is present in the largest quantity, the components that are present in the largest quantity, that we call it as solvent. So here if we took the examples of air, cold drinks and all that, where we mix the multiple components we are mixing together to get a uniform mixture, uniform solution. So here if you take the example of solvent, let's take an example. Here I am taking an example of salt. So here I am taking a salt, a beaker of salt plus water. So what I am doing next, I am going to, this is your salt and this is your water. So what I am doing, in this beaker of water, I am going to add a half a teaspoon a salt. I'm adding the salt. So what is happening after some time? I'm dissolving the solution. What is happening? The salt is dissolved in the water. So here if you see here, the solute. So the components taken in larger amount, larger quantity is your what? Solvent. And the other than that, this component we are taking to add to those solution, that is your solute. So these are the two components in the solution. So one is the solvent, the other one is the solute. Okay, so these two. So solute plus solvent. Solute plus solvent gives you what? Solution. Solute plus solvent gives you a solution. So you are taking a sugar. Sugar is your what? Sugar you are taking in how much amount? A smaller amount. That is your solute. And you are adding the sugar to the water. Water is here what? It is your solvent. When these both combine, the sugar and water, when these both combine, you are getting a sugar solution. So solute plus solvent gives you a solution. So these are what? Binary solutions. So to make a solution, you need a solvent, one solvent and one solute, and these two combine to make a binary solution. So examples of a salt solution is salt plus water, and sugar solution is that is sugar plus water. So based on this, we are going to see the types of solutions. So this much time we are telling what are homogeneous solutions and what is a solution, what are homogeneous mixtures, what are mixtures. Homogeneous means same composition, they are in uniform composition, and heterogeneous, they are in what? They are in non-uniform composition, they are not uniform in composition. So examples is of other solutions like what, bad, cold drinks, these all gases mix and they combine to give the same composition of air and liquids, which are cold drinks, tea, coffee and all. And next